Abnormal embryos could be affecting your chances for first-time IVF success. Embryo testing using PGD or PGS can help identify abnormal embryos, but does the type of testing make a difference? Find out in today's episode of Infertility TV. Here is the simple explanation. Most of the embryos that humans make are abnormal. Normal embryos have a certain number of chromosomes, 23 from the mother and 23 from the father, a total of 46. If an embryo has more or less than that, it is considered abnormal. Three things happen to abnormal embryos if they are placed into the uterus. 1. They fail to implant and you don't get pregnant. 2. The embryo implants but later miscarries. Chromosome abnormality is the most common cause for miscarriage. 3. The embryo implants but doesn't miscarry. These will result in babies with birth defects like Down syndrome. We have excellent evidence that testing embryos for chromosome abnormalities in older women will increase the chance for pregnancy, reduce the risk for miscarriage, and reduce the chance for those birth defects. However, there are different technologies for testing embryos, and they don't all work the same. The oldest technology, known by its acronym FISH, only looks at a few chromosomes. It really has no place for chromosome screening today. A newer technology known as Array CGH was a significant improvement over FISH in that it looked at all 23 pairs of chromosomes. It is still in common use today. The most recent technology is Next Generation Sequencing, or NGS, which also has the ability to look at all 23 pairs of chromosomes, but has the further ability to identify some types of structural abnormalities and cases where an embryo has a mixture of different chromosome types, a problem known as mosaicism. In 2018, researchers looked at 1,000 cases in which couples had a single embryo transfer after chromosome testing by either Array CGH or NGS. Their findings are very important for you. They found that the ability of an embryo to implant in the uterus and continue as a normal pregnancy was better for NGS than for Array CGH. Our Infertility TV bottom line is, until a better technology comes along, next generation sequencing is the best method for embryo testing and results in nearly a 10% increase in the chance for an ongoing pregnancy. There are many other things you need to know about embryo testing. Make sure you check out this playlist about embryo testing. If you like this video, remember to like this video. Have a question? Leave it in the comments below. Click the link in the description to become a new patient, or just subscribe to get new episodes weekly. It's like having an infertility specialist in your phone.